Hey guys, welcome to motorrides.com. This is Amit Changani and we are going to explain in detail how the instrument console of the Yamaha R15 V3 works. And let's start with turning it on first and foremost. So as you can see, it comes with a customized message which at this point in time says hi buddy. And to start off with the basics, you have the fuel gauge here, you have the taco here, the gear indicator is situated here, and this is the speed. Apart from that, you have a shifter light which can come on at a time that you want it to come on after 9000 RPM. And also you can have a look at a lot of other things which include the time as it's showing right now, the fuel efficiency which is liters, shown by liters per 100 kilometers. So it's not KMPL, it's liters per 100 kilometers. So at this point in time it's showing 3.1, which is about 32-33 kilometers per liter if you convert it to KMPL. In addition, you also get your average speed, you get your odo reading, your trip 1, trip 2, and your clock again. Now you can reset it at whichever readout you are. You can just go to reset and long press it. We are not going to do that, but you can actually do that whenever you want to. So for example, if I want to reset this, I just have to long press reset and it will be reset. So the average speed is now reset to 0 kilometers per hour. Apart from that, there are a couple of telltale lights as well. And if you look closely, there is the neutral light here, the engine temperature, the engine status, the turn signals and the high beam. So let me just turn the high beam on. Essentially, yes. So that's the basics, but that's not the end of it. Also, just a second. There is something which is not visible here, but after 7400 RPMs, the variable valve actuation comes into play. And if you look closely, you can see VVA, which is a variable valve actuation. Whenever the variable valve actuation kicks in after 7400 RPM, that lettering comes here to let you know that VVA has been actuated. Also, you can customize the welcome message on the instrument console, as well as the shift point light. When do you want to want it to come on and when you want it to go off? So our friend here from Yamaha will demonstrate how to customize the welcome message and how to customize the shift light. Please sir, go ahead. So this is the reset button that you have to keep pressed, and then you turn the ignition on and you have to keep it pressed at this point in time. And now you can change it by using the select button. So we are not going to change it, but that's how you can change the welcome message. And now we are going to understand how to change the shift points of the RPM light. So for that, you have to press the select button, keep it pressed, and turn the ignition on. Now you can see that the selector light is flashing. Now this one is for brightness. So you can reduce or increase the brightness by using the reset button. As you can see, the brightness is increasing or decreasing. Now when you press select again, the light will start flashing. Pattern. So this is the pattern. You can also select the patterns. This is the one of the patterns where the light is blinking. This is another pattern where the light will blink in slowly, not as fast. And this is the third pattern where the light will stay on. So these are the three patterns for the RPM range where you want the indicator light to come on. These are three patterns you can choose from. Also, you can choose the RPM point where you want it to go off after 9000 RPM. So after 9000 RPM, you can choose where you want the light to come on, right? Yes. So right now we are choosing where it has to come on. So suppose we want it to come on at 10,000 RPM. So what do you have to do for that? Increase the RPM range by pressing reset. So you can go all the way up to 13,000 RPM. Now we are going to start at 10,000 and we want to exit at 11,000. So we defined where we wanted to start by pressing select once, and now we are going to press reset again to go to the point where we want to exit. And now we are going to press select again, and now the light will come on at 10,000 RPM and go off at 11,000 RPM. So that's how the instrument console on the Yamaha R15 works. I hope that this was useful. And we are going to test ride this motorcycle in a bit. Here is a view of the instrument console view again, and stay tuned because we are going to do a very, very detailed review of the R15. In the meantime, we'll just show you how how it works. The setting that we just did, how it works. So if you have a look, when the taco comes here at 10,000 RPM, the light will come on and will go off when it comes at 11,000. Just have a look. I hope that was useful, and thanks a lot for watching. I'll be coming back again with one of the most detailed reviews of the Yamaha R15, so stay tuned. I have created a whole list of questions that people have been asking, and we are going to answer all of them. Thank you very much. Like and subscribe, share with your friends. Bye-bye.